It's the Rhody Roundup, and we're talking about the hot topics that have been making headlines this week. And joining me this morning on our panel is Rhode Show executive producer Ashely Erling, local designer Jonathan Joseph Peters. You know him, you love him. And Deanna Cruz from Hot 106. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
All right, a couple of weeks ago, we heard Beyonce was lip-syncing for the inauguration. Everybody was upset. Yesterday, Beyonce comes out during the NFL press conference. She sings, she wows them, and then at the end, she says, does anybody have any questions? What do we think?
Love it.
I do,
love
too.
It. Awesome. I watched it, and I listened to it, and she sounded absolutely amazing. She sounded exactly like she did when she sang to the backtrack or whatever it was. And then the fact that she ended with, any questions?
Yeah,
I loved it.
I mean, I totally understand. I'm actually lip-syncing this interview right now because I didn't have time to rehearse.
Very common in the industry.
The cold weather does a lot on your vocals.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Beyonce and I, we have that in common among many other things.
And you can dance just like her. Come on.
Exactly.
I love that she waited until the Super Bowl press conference to address it because she hadn't said anything up until that point. And now she's just busy, you know, rehearsing. They did ask her if she was going to be, you know, lip singing at the Super Bowl or what. And she said, no, everything's going to be live just because she had the time to practice and do it and make it perfect. So I'm excited for it. They did ask her if Jay-Z and Destiny's Child were going to come up on stage. And she said with a very, you know, huge smile, I can't really say yes or no. So I think they are.
I wasn't even thinking Jay-Z at first. I'm not really sure why. Yeah. But if he goes out, I'll die.
Ashley was saying this morning, a lot of people are posting that they had no idea that there was going to be a football game around
Beyonce's concert.
But wait a minute, is there a problem that she didn't have time to rehearse for the presidential inauguration because she was rehearsing for the Super Bowl?
Yeah, that's true. That's a really good point.
Elected, you know, president of my country.
She did make a good point, though. She did make a good point that, you know, the inauguration was about the president. It wasn't about her. And then all the attention was going towards her.
Everything's about Beyonce.
She's like, it's not about me, so I'll wear a couture Elisa on and these giant emerald earrings, and my hair will be out to here because it's about Barack.
Since you put it that way, I guess we really do know now.
Yeah.
Another thing that's near and dear to everybody's heart, moguls, Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen, already they have a huge successful fashion line, as everybody knows. They just announced what they're calling an affordable line where they have handbags pricing from $125 to $625. Now, I don't have handbags. I don't know. I do know what expensive is. That seems a little expensive to
me. Pricey.
I am excited to hear what you have to say about this because, as a designer, you might know why they think this is affordable.
Right.
I have no idea why that would be considered affordable.
I'm just wondering if the handbags are going to be large enough that they fit inside.
Yeah, what's the $125 one?
Like, is that for your just your change?
That's the smaller leather goods they said start at $125. I'm thinking keychain.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't really know what you can get for that.
Their line is called The Row, and they were just voted actually one of the, you know, they won actually a fashion award for being one of the most fashion forward, which I understand is
Yeah, they're super successful.
Yeah, absolutely.
But like their line for Walmart was affordable.
Right.
When they were young kids. This is not affordable.
You know, the if the pocketbook, I guess, was $125, not so much. But when it gets up to $625, that seems pricey like the rest of the pocketbook.
That's like their Starbucks bill on a daily basis.
Yeah, I know. That is affordable. They're like, everybody's going to be buying these.
Yeah, what do you mean? You can't afford $600 bags?
I guess when you're a billionaire, $625 is not
You find that in the couch cushions.
Yeah, exactly. They're like, awesome, new bag.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, thanks so much. Jonathan will be showing his line tomorrow at Style Week at the Biltmore. Everybody's looking forward to seeing that. Thank you so much, guys, for being here today. And if you want more information about these stores or about Beyonce, you can head to WPRI.com.